Hey guys, Michael from Cocker Chemistry. In today's video, we'll quickly go over how to find the density and the molar mass of a gas at STP. STP stands for standard temperature and pressure. Standard temperature is 0 degrees Celsius or 273 degrees Kelvin, and standard pressure is 1 atm. Now, if you're at both 1 atm and these temperature conditions, then you're at STP. And what's so special about STP is that at STP, 1 mole of gas takes up 22.4 liters of volume. Now, how to convert between density and molar mass at STP? If you have the density and you want to figure out the molar mass, then you're going to multiply it by 22.4. On the other hand, if you have molar mass and you want to get to density, then you would just divide by 22.4. By the way, the units for density is grams per liter, and the units for molar mass is grams per mole. Great, now let's take a look at two example problems about how to find density and molar mass at STP. So first question, what is the density of nitrogen gas at STP? We're trying to find the density. So then we need to figure out the molar mass so we can go from the right to the left. So first step, find the molar mass of nitrogen. Nitrogen is a diatomic element, so its formula is N2. Let's take a look at the periodic table. You see that each nitrogen's molar mass is 14.007. So we just take this number and multiply by 2 because we have two N's, and that will give us a molar mass of 28.014. So we have the molar mass, we just have to divide that by 22.4, and then we'll get the density. And then when we do that, we get 1.25 grams per liter, because that's the units for density. If you have to show your work through dimensional analysis, this is what you would do. You would do 28.014, and the units for molar mass is grams per mole. Then we would multiply by the conversion factor. We want to cancel out the grams, so we want to cancel out the mole, so we put the moles on the top, and then we put the liters on the bottom. Every one mole, there are 22.4 liters, and then that way the moles cancel out, and you're left with grams per liter, which is the units for density. Great, second problem. What is the molar mass of a gas whose density is 0.761 grams per liter at STP? Now this time, we have the density, and we want to figure out the molar mass, so we're going in the fourth direction. So all we do is just take the density and multiply by 22.4. We'll do 0.761 multiplied by 22.4, and then that'll give us 17.0 grams per mole, because those grams per mole is the units for molar mass. And then if you have to show your work, it'll look as such. You will just multiply by 22.4 liters over 1 mole, so then the liters can cancel out, and then you'll be left with grams per mole. So that's how you can easily find the density and the molar mass of a gas at STP. If you have density, just multiply by 22.4 to get molar mass, and if you have molar mass, divide by 22.4 to get density.
If you want to learn how to ace chemistry, if you want to learn what's the best way to study for this class, if you want to learn some neat tricks and tips to take into your exam and do better on them, then you should head over to my website and get this free guide, 12 Secrets to Acing Chemistry. You can head over to www.conquerchemistry.com/chemsecrets. I'm going to include a link in the description below. Check it out. I think it's really going to help you, and you're going to like it. Until next time, keep working hard and continue the good work.